Welcome to Sound Off. I'm Matt Pinfield, coming to you today from backstage outside of Jones Beach Amphitheater in Long Island, standing next to a tour bus of a band who have been called everything from reggae rock to alternative, but their sound is definitely all their own. And I'm talking about 311. Nick, S.A., what's up, guys? Thanks so much for coming to do Sound Off. Really happy to have you here. Actually,
Good to see you, man.
You're on tour, right?
Our old friend.
Yeah, absolutely.
We go way back.
Way back. I mean, you introduced us here at Jones Beach 9 years ago, but you had me down to your radio station like 14 years ago or something.
Absolutely,
like that.
Yeah, that's right. And we had a great time. That was when music came out.
You were one of the very first 311 supporters.
Definitely.
Absolutely. And still am.
And we thank you for that.
Well, thank you too, guys. I mean, thank you for the great music. And I just want to say, you know, it's really exciting to have you here. And what I love is I come to one of your shows and there's so much passion in your audience. There has been for, you know, every couple of years when you guys do a tour and I come and see you guys play, I'm like, see, nothing's changed. Yeah. Just more new, younger fans. The old fans are still with you. Yeah. It's gotta be fantastic.
It's just getting more and more nuts. Like a couple nights ago in Jersey, we sold out. We had the biggest 311 headlining show. We had a free show in Omaha that was bigger, but this our biggest headlining show ever. 16,600 sold out. We could have sold a couple more thousand tickets. I mean, we don't have any hits on the radio right now. So it's like it's really nuts. And like they were just going crazy. We're just so incredibly fortunate. So every time, you know, I talk and think about our success, I want to take the opportunity to thank the fans out there that made this all possible, because they're just amazing.
They are amazing, you know. And I was told, you know, that was literally the most crowded the lawn has ever been at the PNC Arts Center. One of the biggest turnout of all time. So that's fantastic news. So guys, what I'd love to do is start from the beginning and talk about the origins of 311 and when you guys started.
Well, first, we were born.
Yeah. And after that, how did you end up hooking up with each guy in the band? How did you get to know Chad, Peanut, and S.A., everybody? Let's talk about the
guys. Chronologically, me and Tim had a cover band in high school, and we played the alternative of the time, which was like, you know, The Cure and The Smiths, and
R.E.M.
was still alternative, you know, the underground at that time, and and then right when we graduated high school, we hooked up. Well, I was also in the school jazz band, playing jazz guitar, and Chad was the drummer in there. So right after high school, we found the funk. We hooked up with Chad, me and Tim and Chad, and we started a band called Unity. And we had a keyboard player, and I was the bass player at that time. It wasn't the alternative rock anymore at all. It was funk. It was, we were heavily influenced by Prince and Chili Peppers and, well, Bad Brains isn't funk, but like much more different music than the jangle alternative that we had been playing before with me and Tim. Then Chad went to college for a little while and was your roommate?
No, that's where I met Chad, and prior to that, I had met Peanut, and I ran into Peanut at a house party, and he was downstairs, you know, jamming on the bass, total rock star.
In the garage?
Yeah. 13, you know, and...
couldn't drive. That's
great. I mean, he had the chops then, and so I just was, like, mesmerized, like, man, he's fucking talented, and anyway, so fast forward about a year, I'm in college, and I met Chad. We were on the same dorm floor, and got introduced. We became fast friends. He told me about Nick. He was like, yeah, you gotta meet my bud. He's, you know, he's in LA right now, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, well, you need to meet this kid. You know, Chad was telling me all about his drumming, and so I just thought that naturally he should meet Peanut. And so they did eventually hook up. And then throughout the course of that year in college, Chad would be talking to Nick, okay? And so at this point, Nick convinced Chad to move out to LA, and I think that's when you and Marcus and Chad, that's when Unity LA.
Yeah, then, so in 1990, Chad was like, well, I'm going back to college, and I was like, well, I just decided on a whim to move to Germany, and with a girl that I was dating at that time, And then I called Chad on the phone, and he was like, you know, I hooked up with this great bass player, and he had known that I had wanted to be the lead singer and not play the bass. He was like, when we got this gig opening for Fugazi. Now, Chad's not a big punk rock fan, so that really didn't mean much to him. But to me, opening for Fugazi, that was like, you know, huge. So that I was like, that it would be the greatest launch for our band. I'm coming home. I booked the next ticket home from Germany.
Yeah.
And then we had our first gig opening for Fugazi. And the funny thing was is, I think Chad had a couple gigs with Peanut and another guitarist, and they were called the Fish Hippos. And I was like, I'll be in the band, but I don't want to be called the Fish Hippos.
Good choice. Like, get rid of that name.
I was like, sixteen years later, I think we made the right choice. Yeah, but and absolutely. Peanut had played a talent show and under the name 311 because. His friend, the guitarist, had been arrested for indecent exposure, and that was the police code on the ticket for that particular crime. But Peanut just said, I played a talent show as 311, and I was like, I love it. And then he told me what it meant, and I was like, I still love it. It's great. Yeah. You know, and we didn't really
means nothing. Yeah, I love it.
Absolutely. We didn't really tell people what it meant for a really long time, and that's why people came up with all these different meanings.
That and whole then, bizarre, like, racism KKK
yeah,
thing.
And then, which of was, course,
couldn't most, be, you couldn't be further from that. You
exactly,
guys couldn't be the, further.
The most sensational and, you know, salacious, you know, untrue rumor caught on, and to the point of people, maybe to this day, that aren't informed, not anybody who's really informed about music, but thought that it was true. So it was like a problem for us. To the extent that 311 t-shirts were banned at me and Chad and Tim's high school. And so, but that caught national news, MTV news, everything, and that actually helped break the band. So, I don't know, you know, but it's a really, of course, a terribly negative thing to be associated for people who haven't heard the rumor. It's that 311, that the 11th letter is K, so it means 3K, KKK, and then it's code word for racism. But, you know, essays right. of Latino descent, it's, of course, totally ridiculous that we would be racist, and we're all our lyrics are about, you know, unity and tolerance, and just, like, we would be the last band that should have be
Absolutely.
Associated as
anybody who would listen to your lyrics would know that Absolutely. From minute one, right?
Yeah.
So tell me how that you guys became literally since the Allman Brothers. I mean, obviously there's other great bands that have been on there like Widespread Panic, but since the Allman Brothers, the most successful band that Capricorn had. So I mean, I don't want to jump ahead too far, but you did the three records as 311 beforehand. Let's talk about those three.
Right.
Some of those songs ended up
right
on Music, which was your first Capricorn
90,
record.
Yeah, I did jump ahead. In 1991, yeah. we were based in Omaha.
Yeah.
After we had our opening. Our first gig as 311 was on June 10th in 1990, and then I took out a student loan and financed the recording of a cassette-only album, and then we started selling those and started getting a following going, and then we made a CD called Unity that yeah. contained the original version of the song Unity,
yeah.
which is still a staple of our live shows. And then we also made a cassette EP after that, during those years of 90 and 91. And that was just on our own independent label. I was basically the only employee of the whole thing. I'd take the CDs to the stores and yeah. sell them on consignment and everything.
Yeah.
So then we decided, we got a huge following going in the Nebraska area, and especially Omaha, and we were like, well, we've gone as far as we can go, and SA had been joining us. We would call him up, we're like, we'd like to bring up our man SA, and he would come and do a rap with us, and so then he basically, like, I we we needed some, we loved his raps, and also I wanted someone to sing harmonies, and the other guys were chicken, so. Because, I mean, Tim and Chad can both sing pretty well, but they're chicken. But anyway, so S.A. became full member of the band, fifth member of the band, and then we all decided to move to L.A. together at the beginning of 1992, and we're very fortunate to get signed very quickly, right as the money was running out. We were living on, you know, Top Ramen and care packages of food from our folks and stuff like that, because we just had enough money saved up from our success in Omaha. So we got signed to Capricorn, and we knew nothing about Capricorn, but we just knew that it was a subsidiary of Warner Brothers.
Right.
So we're like, it's a major label. They're going to give us a major label fund, and, you know, we got a big time producer, you know, Eddie Offord, who worked with Yes and everything. We're like, let's, you know, we went for it. So
welcome back to Sound Off. I'm Matt Pinfield, and I'm sitting in the tour bus of Nick Hexum and S.A. Martinez of the band 311. Guys, welcome back to Sound Off. Great to have you guys here. Now, Eddie Offord, who worked on music with you, which was such a great record. I mean, I remember jamming every single off that on the radio down in Jersey. Do You Right, Visit, Feel So Good.
Deep cuts.
Yeah. Eddie Offord was legendary for the work he did with Yes, but there were all these rumors that he had actually gone insane in the studio. So is there any truth to that? And how was it for you to work with him? Was that something that...
We got to witness his decline into insanity, and it was at times funny and at times really, really sad. On the first album, on Music, he didn't drink and he took his medication, and he was like an English gentleman, totally professional, and we just made a fantastic album with him. And so we stuck with him for our second album, Grassroots. And then he started drinking and stopped taking his medication and went
bonkers. As
just
secret,
there's just no, I mean, like, it was a really difficult time for us because he was supposed to be, you know, our producer, kind of
like extra member, the other member,
right?
Because he'd been, because Music had sounded so great, and I mean, the Yes album and records like that are fantastic, still sound great today. So he had that magical touch, but sad thing to have that happen. Now the next album, of course, the third album was the Blue album, the self-titled 311. I remember being at MTV and saying, we got to add this band's video because I'm telling you, these guys are blowing up and they're a great live band. And Don't Stay
and
Home.
Probably, it took a while for you to convince them because that album was out for a year before it really started.
Well, I got them to play it. I added it, but they added it in light rotation. And they added it, they said, on My Passion Alone. I'll never forget that he said that.
You know, we came out with Don't Stay Home first.
First, yeah, and that's the one I got them to add, which is the beach video, which was shot far from where we are today.
Yeah, that's right.
Here on Sound Off.
That's
on
right,
the beach.
That's right. That's a beautiful
And
beach.
Then, of course, you know, with All Mixed Up and Down, which had come after, which things just exploded like I expected them to. How was that for you guys when you were on the road and here you were, you're supporting the record, doing what you always did, building up this audience, and all of a sudden, the media caught up with you guys.
Right.
And radio too.
I mean, honestly, you know, always when we had, you know, huge record sales, you know, and in those days, it was always an abstract thing. I mean, it was like a number. It was something you looked at on paper that really didn't mean anything per se, but really what meant was, you know, our fan base was just growing and growing. At that point, it really was exploding, and so that really was, I think, what caught our attention more so than anything. The fact that we were selling out gigs weeks in advance, you know, that was a huge stepping stone for us. So you know, looking back, I think the great thing about our rise really and our build as a band is that we didn't come out with a huge single that was everywhere, because
like
a lot of
on a debut.
A lot of times
might not be able to handle it.
Yeah, a lot of times that happens to bands, and you know, they don't see that translation, and as when tour comes around, they're not getting the adulation that they are commercially, you know, by selling these records. But so for us, it was building it, you know, fan by fan, and then all of a sudden we had some commercial success, which was nice, but really the meat and potatoes was still growing, and to this day continues. So that was really, I think, a blessing for us that it happened the way it happened.
That's totally true, because, like, on the Music and Grassroots tour, we did like 150 shows to support each of those albums. So our chops as musicians, by the time the Blue album blew up and we were playing for places just like Jones Beach, huge, we were ready. You know, we were totally ready, because some bands just can get thrown in the fire before they really are ready for it.
Now, of course, after that album, things exploded. And I mean, you already had built up that huge fan base. So coming after that with Transistor and Sound System, did you feel pressure during the making of those records? Or did you just say, you know, we're going to kind of approach this the way we always have? And how was the writing process at that point? Because you were
My recollection of it was that we were going to do the opposite of conventional wisdom, which was give Blue Album Part 2, which would have been an automatic seller.
Yeah.
Transistor was... It was a double length album, 21 songs. You know, if it would have been on vinyl, it would have had to be, well, it would
be. It was.
Yeah.
You know, and they were a lot of really experimental sounds. We were getting really turned on it, like trip hop, like Portishead and Massive Attack at that time. So there's
Shadow
a lot
and all those people, right?
Yeah, definitely. It's and so there's like a lot of like samples, and we were really getting into reggae. And as far as like modern rock, there's like Beautiful Disaster and maybe a couple other songs, and that's about it. Most of it was not what had made us successful. So we took a big artistic chance and took a leap, and a lot of people didn't like it. But now, after years looking back, it's a lot of people's favorite album.
I love the fact that you've always done that, and you've said, well, the audience has to go with us. So in retrospect, people have lived with the album. And they love it now.
Yeah.
Your fans, you're looking at some of the fan sites, and they do. They love the album.
Yeah.
Also because there's a lot more there for them to choose from. So it's like, it's why I ask some people, what's your favorite Beatles album? The White Album. Because there's more of it. Which is crazy.
Makes sense.
And that's a good thing, though. You know,
look at it that way.
And so, I think that's kind of what the stage, personally, where I feel that we're at as a band right now. Because, like, from going from Evolver to Don't Tread on Me went back to back. It went, like... Evolver tour right in the studio with Don't Tread on Me, record it, hurry and get back out there on the road. So there wasn't this sort of like, you know, it was just, let's just give them, you know, a great 311 straight up the middle album, you know, with, I mean, there's still experimental stuff. There always will be in 311, but it was recorded in like a quarter of the time that the previous album was. So I think we're at kind of a place that maybe we were before Transistor, where like we're kind of trying to think, okay, now how can we step forward? We don't want to just make, you know, reggae rock forever. Like, how are, I mean, those are, we still have those elements, but you know, what, where is our path leading us next? And so we're gonna kind of take a little time to sit back and kind of collect our thoughts and pick up new influences. And And so it probably will be, take a little longer to make this next album.
Welcome back to Sound Off. I'm still hanging out right now with Nick and Essay from 311. We were talking about love songs before. Your cover of Love Song went straight up to number one on the alternative charts.
Actually, the idea to do this, do Love Song, was Adam Sandler's.
Yeah.
And he said, and he loved the song Amber, and he wanted that to be the sort of template of how he wanted 51st States to sound. And so he was like, see if you can make a cover of Love Song, generally in the style of Amber, you know, the romantic reggae, which is kind of, I mean, lover's rock is a genre in Jamaica, but it's nothing that's like sort of busted out worldwide, you know what I mean?
Yeah, lover's rock's cool. It's been around since the 70s.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I mean, literally since the beginning of the 70s. And
absolutely.
Clash even had a song called Lover's Rock.
That's true.
On London Calling, one of the greats, you know, so.
Yeah.
So they brought attention to it back then. But lover's rock is cool. Are you a fan? Do you check out some of the lover's rock? Have you historically gone back on
that stuff? I'm a reggae historian, for sure.
That's great.
Like, I put together mixed CDs that play for when the people are walking in, of like, you know, obscure, cool cuts from everyone from Burning Spear to Peter Tosh.
And Max Romeo, all those guys, Junior Mervin, they're all great, aren't they? Delroy Wilson, I love all that. The old reggae stuff is so cool, right?
Definitely.
It's awesome.
Yeah. Speaking of which, you got the Wailers on tour with you.
Exactly.
It's an honor.
Legends.
I mean, you guys are huge Marley fans, so is it cool having some of the original guys come out and do some of those classic tracks that they were a part of the original?
Yeah, and to hear their stories about all the...
What kind of Bob Marley stories have they told?
Well, really cool? Al Anderson, the guitarist, you know, he was basically the first day of that we really hung out, him and I, he was telling me that that Bob wrote a lot of those songs on an out-of-tune guitar, you know?
And you know that one famous picture of him that's on the box set? There's a string missing. Like Bob was not like a player. Like he had an incredible voice, incredible songwriter, but he didn't really like arrange those songs. And Al said, "We made up those parts. We made up those, you know." And so it's a little sad that the Wailers are out here promoting Bob Marley songs.
You know? Yeah.
And then people go and they buy the records, but the Wailers don't get a penny of it.
That's
got all the publishing, him and Chris Blackwell. You know, so there's some bitterness there, but still they love the music, and you know they love the memory of Bob and stuff, and they tell cool stories about those last years, and you know, like conspiracy theories of was he poisoned because you know, like FBI had like this big file on him because he was like, you know, subversive, and he was like friends with like, you know, I don't know, Che Guevara or whatever. You know, there's all this sort of
Those conspiracy theories are pretty interesting. They really are. Stories have been incredible. Left us with a great legacy of music, and those guys are so super talented. It's cool that you're bringing them out and have them on the road, which is
great.
They get the crowd ready. It's get the crowd going.
I want to talk about 311 Day and how amazing that is. As a fan of your music, and I know I can speak for myself, but other fans, to go and see you guys do 68 or 64 songs in a row, like the one you did in New Orleans, and of course this year, Memphis. Tell me what made you guys decide to do this and make this thing actually come to fruition?
Well, it was something that our fans pointed out to us, you know, 311, that's a date. You guys should do something special on that day. And so I think the first 311 day was like 8 years ago.
It was like a non-event, pretty much.
It was just
a regular show.
It's like something we put on the poster.
Yeah,
you know, 311 day. We just, you know.
So for how many years now has it been?
We've had three extravaganzas.
Okay.
And and the last one was in Memphis, of course, recorded by HGNet. We're going to be mixing it in 5.1 surround sound, and that's on HGNet. That's going to be like sort of a 90-minute like best of 311 day.
Badass! It's a great channel.
So it's good. Good little
it's
way
awesome
to
channel.
Throw in a plug there. Yeah. I'd like to thank Mark Cuban for.
Mark's great, man.
He's great, and I got to also give him props for, you know, I think Dan Rather really got a raw deal.
He sure did, man.
Yeah.
And I'm really got to give Mark props for giving Dan his own show.
Mark's cool, man. He's a visionary. I love that.
He is,
and
man.
He's not afraid to take chances.
And if you email him, he'll email you back within a minute. He's like always on his BlackBerry.
Mark's great, man. He's totally cool. I mean, I'm really excited to be a part of the channel.
His email address is...
There you go. Tell him how much you love the show, which is great. Now, so it's going to be edited down on a special on there. That's going to be cool. That's really... Nick, let's talk about also, you've got this nonprofit organization that you have about global warming. Let's talk about that.
Yeah, you know, I'd been concerned by, well, my father's a scientist, and, you know, I follow science in general quite a bit, and I've been concerned about, you know, global warming just gradually over the years. And then last year, you know, I have a place down in Florida Keys, and that got hit by four hurricanes. And any meteorologist will tell you that the strength of the hurricane is caused by the temperature of the water. And at this point last year, the Gulf was 4 degrees warmer than usual, okay? So that caused Katrina, Wilma, Rita, and actually Dennis was the first one. But Wilma was the one that hit me the hardest down in the Keys. So it kind of took on a personal thing because I as geoscientist, meteorologist, are in agreement. There's no more like this whole, you know, well, we're not sure if global warming is real. That's over. In the real scientific community, that's over. There are people who are at petroleum companies who are trying to spread disinformation, and they've in fact hired some of the same PR firms that the tobacco companies used to hire to say, well, we're not sure if smoking's addictive, we're not sure if it causes cancer, because they're just trying to, you know, hang on to what they've got for as long as they can. But it's the scientific jury is in, and the fact is that we as a people have to cut our CO2 emissions, and or we're going to have more and more disasters like heat waves, which cause wildfires, like incredible storms that cause floods, hurricanes. They call them cyclones down in Australia. And I mean, of course, the raising tides, because I mean, you know, and so liberalhexam.org is a nonprofit organization that I started to raise awareness. So you can see I'm getting all worked up because I'm really passionate about it. But liberalhexam.org is it's a registered 501c nonprofit organization. So if you make a donation, it's like tax deductible. And I launched it by running the LA Marathon this year, which was very difficult. But liberalhexam.org is a website which is basically it's a primer course. It's global warming, climate change 101. It's bullet points of what causes it and what's going to happen and what we can do to stop it. You know, I drive a hybrid car. I've got a solar system on the Florida house, and I'm looking to put one on my LA house. And you know, we all have to, it's going to affect all of us. It's something that, you know, really we can't ignore any longer, you know. And Bush not signing the Kyoto Treaty is just plain wrong. I understand his reasons for not doing it, because he said, well, China's not going to do it, so I'm not going to do it. Well, just because they're being dirty doesn't mean that we need to be dirty, because we like take up so much of the fossil fuels, and of like 5% of the population, and we take and we put out 25% of the emissions. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's like we're pigs, yeah. And we need to look at that, because it's going to affect everybody, and it's going to cause like massive flooding in like Bangladesh and places where we will see suffering on
a massive
scale, like the tsunami, but worse.
Yeah, absolutely, guys. I really appreciate you doing today. One last question for USA. What do you, after this tour, you think you guys are going to get right back into the writing side of things and do another record? Or have you decided you're going to tour for a while?
We're going to finish this tour and take some time off. And, you know, but we will reconvene as a band at some point in the near future.
Yeah, well, we're excited about it. Guys, it's so great to be with you again. It's been, I've been hanging with you guys for about 14 years now. And
you've been there.
Yeah, absolutely. It's exciting to see you guys
Big thank you to you. Big thank you to the 311 fans.
Great, thank you for your show too. This is a great show, and it's awesome to have in high def.
Yeah, thanks a lot. I appreciate it, guys. Excellent. Well, everybody, hope you enjoyed the show tonight. This is Sound Off from myself, Nick Hexum, S.A. Martinez. Have a good night.
Better than you, then it's time for gotta do to get the people on the soul of everyone gather. The more, the better. I represent the drama. Here be the strata, come on. What's up, Memphis? Happy 311 Day! Yeah. It's finally here.
Get on, what you say? mess. St. Louis Supreme, and on my team, I rock the mic with a sweet link. You know that, stated as a fact. The only DJ amps are getting down like that. Metaphorically, we are the chief of police, your rock and roll. And we're positive, you're so more than just the radio. Now it's 2-6, and we are back in control. The governor coming, who's a coming? We got the soul.
Pretend to bug it upon a green tree. Harvard degree. You can't make me hate you, no matter how punk you act. No matter what you do, I don't react. I'm a perfect example. I'm not giving a fuck about the catty rude people. They just suck when you know. All of a sudden, I usurp you. Look it up in the dictionary to find out what I do. I go back to the style I came from. It's not something you can't fake, son. You're a kind of man whose run is done. You need a world wide web of deception.
Pretend to forget upon re-entry. Oh, this is gonna fit with me or leave. Made of rubber fat into naturally. You did the highlights of technology. It's only right by. It's an interface of your little light. Next attention on the genus tie. This one data is different from my side.
From chaos comes clarity. I tell y'all what you appear to be.
Because
So how we doing out there? Let's keep it going now. Here's an old one called Freak Out. Just take your mouth off.
want to get next to them. My name is Nick, H-E-X-U-M.
So how are we doing so far?
I've been this way a long while. I surely like to rest, but the energy So what's up, y'all?
Got to my mind. There's something I need to get on my chest. No matter what, we come to shine. Dream it away.
Bring it down, bring it down. What's up, Memphis? It's 311 day.
Chips in my heart, so easy. Your choice again. We've got, our candidates are running or use of time. Hey, who wants to hear running? Who wants to hear use of time? We got it. Once again, let's hear it for Tim Mahoney, y'all. So what's up? Y'all still with us out there? Yeah.
human drama in a reggae bird.
Gone if you blink, I can see it as soon as you think it.
Cars, crystal balls, a sidewalk, Mars, psychic people, outdoors reading palms.
I believe that you know more.
Grassroots.
I'm flipping the kick and tripping it, so I can check shit. Not in a daily style, but once and every while, so I can foul check the balls of my brain.
who come from the insane and the butcher, the baker, the pepper, the drama maker, a cracker on a truck going breaker, breaker. Listen to everyone, then disregard it. The meaning of nigga back, back to where it started in your cranium, surrounded by pot like a geranium. A capital two burns in my mind. Give me some peace. I looked at her, I looked at him, and neither one to know where the wild thoughts grow. Check it out. I looked at the loose end. Absolutely none. Truth is what you shoot for, not one. We've been drinking all together. The journey's never done. I've been storming the weather, but it's been long. So let's have some fun.
311 has grassroots. Come on, jump. 311 has grassroots. True. 311 has grassroots for you, mama. 311 has grassroots.
Shaman comes and goes, and there will be another. I'll savor it on. The roots that grow underground are as big as the tree. As you see, if not, it will fall down. We waste so many moments standing on convention. The only survey.
Cover much distance, knowing no pedestrian, that's my game. For instance, 311 true to no tradition, and the 311 crew. Now we can convince you, but 100 different people already told what we about. So I make no attempt to try and suss this stupid out. I turned into a roughneck, that was not my intention. It doesn't even really matter, let the fail to mention that piece of war group that wants to be. First the men in the west, then we slide through the east. Piece of any crew that wants to be. The piece of war crew that wants.
I looked at the loose end, absolutely none. The truth is but shoot for now one. Nothing brings it all together. The journey's never done. I'd be charmed the weather, but it's been sung. So let's have some fun.
311 has grassroots. Come on, jump. 311 has grassroots. True. 311 has grassroots for your mama.
1. We want to see if we get everyone in this whole motherfucking place just jumping up to the beat. All is one.
Nod your head to this. There's a lot to predict. Some of this. We're standing on the shoulders of giants. Sometimes I'm benevolent. To the followers, it's relevant. The rest gets bent on things. Thing opinions I'm sending.
Check. Through my rock now. I'm so bound, yeah, you're so sound. Cool, the blue. were shady. A little ugly too, yeah, and too we are. But this music will come and not wood we speak. We a red, gray, beach, try to rash it off the
platter. Oh yeah.
Titty batter, come on, Larry Scott.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, yeah, Chad Sexton.
People never see
Hey, y'all. Mr. Chad Sexton on the drums.
Really?
Smooth yet psychedelic, it's called the Knicks Hex. Dig it. Song's over. Before we take a short break, I think it's time to say, Peanut, beat that thing. This one's called Feels So Good.
With us, y'all. on someone from so far. It's so good any day. What you think a solid earth can't jump up and spread out to the north and south. That's what plates are about. Nature has no content, no kindness or a clue. But
dreams they hide make me sad because of the thoughts that they will walk against the fire and rust. Then it happened to me and my family. My prison, I was driving the RV, bleeding in flames, sleeping in fire, surviving zone winner. Room there was far on it.
We're coming in, how we will. Want to tell the whole world what's the deal? And I said, no, no credit card for that, cause we do what we want. Got more funky styles, release the checkup on. I want to get over, signing with the norm.
Friendly to the radio, all that shit is gone. All we coming with is a little bit of swing. And we go on
like it ain't no thing.
We say
Omaha and dialing did nothing. There was one way another. Rangers we and the shows are more fun.
Know it.
Fuck up the dance hall since 88. Man, it did nothing when here we come from this stage.
Stupid town like that, stupid town like that, stupid town like that. Think
my focus rules is gone. Omaha and Stiley did nothing, there was one way another. Rage is weak and the shows are more fun than I know it. Fuck up the dance hall since 88. Man, it did nothing when here we come from this stage. The dance hall that we come from was a pool table basement. The blood was low, we
such occasions occur back in the day. It begins your rocket all the way. Son of a gun, but then you drink it. Or it's out of you, a gifted. At the break of dawn, behaving like a spy. Lemon in the life, the cold world awakens. Deeper is the light to open up the sky. Look into my eyes, see them dilating. All my styling is the shit we come with, man. Embedded in a soul that brings out from this band. Always knew that.
Fuck up that dance hall since 88. Mean we did nothing when here we come from this state.
Stupid town like that, stupid town like that, stupid town like that.
Picking up all that from the score.
We will arise, explore these worlds and find the grassroots. How to cruise and do the grinding on the ground to brew. A two on the one.
One.
Come on my Teflon, rock that shit and rock.
If you're up on my arm, standing in your field, say, do as you will, do as you wish. Follow your bliss. Around the country, giving it the best. I like to see the people dancing and bouncing and the rest.
The hammer and the chisel and the rule, the compass. We forge the sword, the chariot, supper, a battle mask.
There's much power in anger. The love's a big appeal to bleed from to my crew.
Right,
this is how we do. Omaha Style. How we doing out there? Any different people can't apply to drop the punk. It's not a country club review, it's any talk of junk. Many people would have it, others go out and grab it. Some jump on the roofs and say, fuck it, I'm sunk. I poured it in a limerick and kick the slick neck verbs. I'm the one that scores the herb. When we're on the road, peanut rolls are up. Throw me a joint on stage, what's up? I will tell a cop that I know my fucking rights. And we can match wits all night, for real. He said if I had nothing to hide, then of course I wouldn't mind if he looked through my ride, man. No, I'd really rather you did it. And no, we don't have guns, hit it. Looking for a while, I continue to decline. Firm, didn't lose my mind. Didn't let him break me, he's just another human. Not a bit of shame. What we were doing that day, couldn't make a stay. Had it shit together, doesn't matter whether we sport the dreadlocks or the shaved head, or if we ever stick up from the dead. I said a better verse for your about the revenue curse that we can keep an evil deal about and play some bass of music every minute.
story stands for crime and no victim. When everybody knows jail terms should be picked in order of the pain that they cause. Do what they will to be the whole of the law until you violate the rights of a nun. Respect the face of your sister and your mother. The war on drugs may be well intentioned, but it falls fucking flat when you start to mention an overcrowded prison where a rapist gets paroled. To make room for a dude who is full pound of weed, to me that's a crime. It's the good people doing time, y'all. Come on.
So what's up, y'all still with us out there? How about on this side? How y'all feeling? Over here, what's up with you? People in the back. Now down on the floor, let me hear it. This one's called Come Original.
Come original, got to come original, got to come original, I'll entertain us, come original, got to come original, got to come original, I'll
Now here's one we like to call the Happy Slam Dance song, Do You Right.
Is a gift, I know.
crack, a flash of lightning on to the next plane. So remain, come along if you dare. It's gonna be that show scare. A lovely life, I thank you for the reason to see the pain. Thank you. my brain, reminding me that no one sings, not all the time. Yes, I still remember you in a way that you want me to. I'm in a man who no one will do right for you. Plainly, you waited on pins for me, but needle never ever long. What did you think of? Hey, y'all, let's hear it for Peanut on the bass and Tim Mahoney on guitar. So the question is, who's got the Hey, y'all. Gotta tell you, today is the stuff dreams are made of, man. We were pulling up on our bus, seeing all y'all run up, seeing all this. Words can't describe, but maybe a song can. We'd like to dedicate this next song to all the old school 311 fans in the house tonight. Been down with us all these years. Much Love is called Down.
Bottom of stock as my evil becomes a bookie child with some more than my tongue. Be like, can't take a breath, my mouth is loose. And while I scatter my spit, I dream of Jews. Times I ever made out in dark hallways. Display a kiss that made your day. I say, play the track from your record collection. I sure miss congratulations.
You can't a lot of this song, some know that we have always been down, down. If I ever didn't thank you, you.
Too bad I'm from the start of the show, but I mean now. Merry Christmas, because I told you so. You know, we glow because we throw some red. Yeah, baby, we got a shed. Hey.
Between a lot of this, some know that we have always been down, down. If I ever didn't thank you, then let me do it now. It's almost midnight, and we would like to thank you for making this the best 311 day ever so far. Much respect. At midnight, we turn into pumpkins. We got time for one more song. Just got one more thing to say. Fuck the bullshit, it's time to throw down!
Boom! It's the bullshit, what it is, here it is!
Fucking 311!
I said, son, what it is, here it is!
Fucking 311!
But the bullshit is what it is, here it is!
You know I'm ready, yes, rock steady. My name's not Betty or Teddy, but Nick. And I'm much of my car, a heretic. Yes, and I am from Nebraska. My God, that's how to fight, you can ask her. Where the oil was built, that drunk ain't that dead. You've been killed for polluting the sea. Plus a deep, still on free. Well, this one goes to a bird that drown.
But the bullshit, it's time to throw it down. But the bullshit, it's time to throw it down. But the bullshit, it's time to throw. But the bullshit, it's time to throw it down.
Just fuck the bullshit, tune it in, feast and pain. They can turn it all down, so what's an end? Words of wisdom that keep y'all guessing. Tired of playing and tired of messing around. All the suckers
bullshit, it's time to throw down. The bullshit, it's time to throw move. The bullshit, it's time to throw. The bullshit, it's time to wet move.
Yeah, right about now, I'd like to turn old Mike, my man, S.A.
The myth and the mismaster, number destructor, lyric doctor, rolling with the rhythm while I'm rolling. But the motherfucker when it starts bad, nigga, bulls, hardies, guys are dead. I'm the B-boy, like a bigger fool, the Thor, 311, never die high, y'all a mug, who I hope it. Cornstream, when I fire up a judge, and I'm looking peanut. The phantom is living in your mind, the rhythm is doing what?
Piece of the inside, the year to the T.
Whoop that trip, whoop that trip.
Happy 311 day. Keep it on the positive. Thank you.